back to my channel. I'm Mara Victoria Dior, and today I decided to do a makeup look inspired by fairies and unicorns, and I was like, you know what, if a fairy were to cry, this is probably what it would look like. So this is definitely giving me some like Coachella vibes, some like EDC vibes. If I were to go to EDC, I would totally do this, but I'm not. So, oh, there go my tears. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe. You know, I don't know. I think that's all I have to say. Oh, I cut my hair. I mean, granted, I was wearing like 24-inch extensions from Luxury for Princess. Get yours at luxuryforprincess.com today. Yeah, I did take them out, but I also did get a haircut and I just ditched the extensions and I was like, you know what? I feel brand new, okay? New year, new me. We're in April, but it's fine. If you guys want to learn how to get this look, then keep on watching. We're going straight in with brows. I'm gonna go in with Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade. I use this every single day. And it's so much, like, I don't even know when I got this, and it's really nice. It's long lasting. It's definitely a dramatic look, but it's long lasting. It lasts me all day. It won't budge. And then I use it with Glamour by Josue's collaboration with Crown Brush, and this is the a brow duo. First things first, I'm just gonna comb my hair, brow hair upwards. I'm gonna brush it upwards just so I can see my sparse areas. So I'm gonna start at the beginning of the brow, creating a like sort of straight line under. That might have been a little too low, but I'm just kind of drawing a line underneath my brow, and I'm gonna follow it all the way across. Sometimes it's perfect. Sometimes it's a mess. And then now I'm gonna grab a little bit more. Not too much. Sorry, because I'm wiping it off on my hand right now. So not too much. And actually, I'm gonna brush this up, and then I'm gonna fill it in, stroking upwards. Sometimes it can get a little crazy. So after going upward, I'm just gonna kind of follow the way my hair naturally goes. And then I'm gonna bring it down, connecting the two lines. And I'm just gonna keep filling in. And this is me, like, I haven't done my eyebrows in so long. So this is me trying to work with an eyebrow that's not done. But if it were, I feel like if I had threaded them, it would have been so much easier. So much easier. Alright, same thing with this side. I'm gonna start in the middle. The beginning, and then create a line going across and down with small brush strokes. Not too crazy. You don't want to get too crazy just yet. So some days my eyebrows are so perfect. Other days they're not. They're definitely sisters. They're definitely cousins. They're not even sisters. Okay. Then I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Max Pro Longwear Concealer. This is an NC30. And I'm gonna clean up my under eye as well as bring down the concealer and use it on my lid as a primer. You could definitely use an eye primer your liking, but I'm definitely gonna use concealer just because it's easier and I love that super clean canvas look that it gives me in my eyes. So now I'm gonna go in with Be Bella's brush. This is their flat brush in NG352. And I'm just gonna use her to help me keep that straight line and clean up my under eye. Under my eyebrows. Thank you. Okay, so now that I have brought her down into my eyelid, I'm going to take this Bella Cosmetics small buffer brush, and this is an NG311, and I'm going to blend the concealer. This little dense brush is really going to diffuse the color into my skin, and I love this like sharp, clean look. Alright, and then I'm blending her down. And also, if you do not like this super white cast on your eye, you can always use foundation, like your skin tone foundation, and just clean up your eyebrows just like that. It's the same thing, but I just like to have this little highlight under my eye. Okay, so now that I have blended everything out, I'm going to quickly set the concealer on my lid, because I feel like if I don't set it right now, I'm gonna start creasing, and it's so hard to like either blend or take out creasing for me. I feel what I'm gonna do is I am gonna go in with, this is MAC Studio Fix Powder in NC30, I believe, and I'm just gonna set this very quickly on my lids. This is also going to be an amazing base for our eyeshadows, and applying powder and powder on powder blending is actually really easy, instead of you having cream under and then trying to blend powder, because it gets stuck, it kind of stays there, and you're trying to blend and it doesn't move, and then you start to freak out. So powder on powder blending is the best. Okay, so now I'm gonna set my eyebrows. This is Anastasia Beverly Hills brow gel in granite, and this is going to hold your hair in place all day, and it's not gonna move. And this is from Anastasia, and this, I love this one. This is a really nice one. Now I'm going to use Beauty Creation's new Boudoir shadows. Hello. Alright, so I'm so excited. Look how fucking gorgeous these shadows are. When I saw this, I was like, this is their new palette. This is their new eyeshadow palette. And I love this. Like, this is so pretty. If you guys are interested in the Beauty Creations palette, I'm also giving away one on my Instagram right now. So if you guys are interested, go and figure out how to enter this giveaway. This one's a cooler tone, just as pretty. And I love this. Makes me so happy. But for today, I'm gonna be using the warmer shade palette, because duh, that's like what I do. And I'm gonna go right in. So picking up our first shade, probably this little gorgeous, I always gravitate towards these. And I'm gonna apply this to my crease, blending her away, because you know, we want her to be mystical and So I'm going to be using this glitter from NYX. This is in crystal and it's so pretty. I love it and I'm so excited to use it on my lid because it's so like funky. Alright, so I'm going to be applying that with a brush I kind of don't care about, sort of, I guess. So I'm going to apply a little bit of the glue on my lid first and then I'm going to let it get a little tacky and then right after I'm going to apply the glitter. Alright guys, wish me luck. I'm using lit glue. Alright, so I just applied it a little to my brush. So this is exactly why we do our face makeup after, because everything falls. I'm loving how this is coming out. I was like, yes. I'm gonna put on a little bit of eyeliner. I'm just gonna put a little bit on the outer corner, or maybe I should not. Should I? I will, you know what? And I mean like a little wing. Because I think it's cute. I was like, you know what? I think she needs a wing. Now I'm gonna apply this little bit of mascara. This is Too Faced Better Than Sex sample mascara. So I'm just gonna apply a few generous layers of mascara on my eyelashes. And then I'm gonna go in with some gorgeous lashes. So we're gonna be using Be Bella Cosmetics lashes in Maya. I love these lashes. They're like my third time wearing them and they're actually really nice. I'm gonna put on these bad boys, take off this glitter, put on my face makeup, and then I'm gonna work with my bottom. So I apply foundation, concealer, I sort of baked a little, and then put on some of Pure Cosmetics 4-in-1 Pressed Mineral Makeup as my bronzer, which is actually, I really like this. It's really nice. Now I'm gonna go in with this Beauty Creations Angel Glow. Just wanna show you this beauty real quick. So now I'm gonna go in with Be Bella's amazing highlighting brush in NG321. And I'm gonna apply it in this gorgeous shade. And this is the darkest shade. Maybe I'll mix the two. And I'm gonna apply it to the high points of my cheeks. Oh yeah, this is so pretty. Oh, I love this so much. Love this so much. It gives you like dewy skin. Oh yes, come through. How pretty, how gorgeous. Alright, so for this makeup look, you can stop here. This is a normal, this is a halt. You could have stopped a long time ago. You could have stopped at the glitter, at the wing, at the false lashes. Maybe not the highlight. Don't stop here, you know, keep going. You could have stopped there, but I'm gonna keep going. I really wanted to apply some glitter at the kind of falling down. Like, if I'm a crying fairy, you know, that's what it would look like. Oh my gosh, I really love this so freaking much. Like, I tried it on my wrist, but I didn't try it on my skin, and I'm going to go back into my palette and I'm going to create a warm, the same hue that we did around the crease. I'm going to try to mimic that and bring that to the bottom. So we're just going to smoke this bad boy out. So So that's the black, and then I'm gonna go back into this burgundy, warm burgundy shade, create that same hue. Yes! I love this palette. Wow, really, really, really good formula. The packaging is the cutest. Okay, so I brought it pretty low. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I did bring it pretty low. But now I'm gonna go in with the glitter, apply a little bit of glue, and then the glitter, obviously. Actually, I'm gonna face down so the glitter falls straight and not on my face. So give me 2 seconds. How pretty, I love it. I feel so pretty now. Like, I feel like I wish this is how I cried all the time. Applying some glue, and then going in with the glitter. I'm gonna apply some mascara to the little hairs that are left on the side. I'm gonna try to give him some life with mascara. I'm actually really digging this. Like, this is what I had in mind in my head, but you know, it always comes out different when you actually do it. You're like, maybe I shouldn't have done that. I love how dramatic it is. Like, oh my gosh, we get it, you're here. For lipstick, I'm gonna use this Smashbox cream lipstick palette. This is such a nice palette, I just got it. I'm gonna line my lips. Alright, so I'm gonna grab maybe this gorgeous color here first and see how that goes. So bushy. I'm like, why are you so worried? This is their new palette. If you guys are interested in these